Good morning, La Union! It's my second day in beautiful San Juan, and I'm just in time for the sunrise. Today is going to be a beautiful day, I'm sure of it. This is Orbistondo, about 4 hours away from Manila and the main surfing beach on the strip. Drop by early in the morning and you'll likely see Luke Landrigan, Phil-Australian pro surfer and founder of San Juan Surf School. If you're lucky, he may even be your teacher. Let's listen in. Luke says, start by getting to know your surfboard. Then he does a demo of what you're supposed to do in the water.
So first, you lap down like this. Stretch your toes. And lift up like this. Then, the instructor will push you from behind, but at the same time, the student needs to paddle also. So when you paddle, just paddle alternate left and right. Chin up like this. When the instructor pushes you on a wave, you will feel that the board is gonna go a little bit faster. That means you're catching the wave already.
He says, when you feel you're confident to stand up, push your body upwards, stand straight, and that's that. That was surfing 101. Not exactly my cup of tea, but the perfect way to work up an appetite. Luke's 3-year-old daughter Luna is here too, and together, they prepare to catch the waves. I leave the surfing to Luke and Luna and gladly head to breakfast. Seabuds at San Juan Surf Resort is run by Luke's partner and Luna's mom, Danica. Seabuds, she says, is all about mindful eating. What I requested for was a big traditional Filipino breakfast.
I call it the vegan silog meals. It's tapa, tocino, bacon, and longanisa, but they're not real meat. It's made from soybean protein, and then we just put spices to make it taste like the real thing.
Really surprised me. Listen to that crunch, diba? So you can eat and not feel guilty. Oh my gosh, this is so my type. That bacon was like the real thing. Pasadong pasado. Okay, let's give this vegan tocino a try. I'll try it on. Hindi masarap. Medyo sweetish ng konti, just like tocino, but it's very good. I'm very impressed. And you know what? It's guilt-free. This is great. No one ever told me plant-based could be this good. Even the eggs are not eggs, but made of tofu. It's delicious. Long silog up next. Okay then. Of course, it doesn't have the same texture as longganisa, but the same flavor. Winner! Sarap ha. Ang galing nila, nakakabilib. Ang sarap nito. And now for my favorite, tapsilog.
You know, they have ano eh, this, you know what works perfectly with it also? Is their sukang Iloco. Ang sarap niya. Tapos, brown rice pala yung sinangag with tofu scrambled eggs, or at least it looks like that. Tomatoes and cucumber. Alam mo, it works so well. I am shocked. and dumbfounded at how good this is.
Food, I feel like it's supposed to energize you, not make you feel sleepy or lazy. So I'm more energized when I eat fruits and vegetables throughout the day.
I am honestly considering shifting to a plant-based diet after this, and I agree with everything Danica said.
Pero sarap, grabe.
The smoothie bowls are also a must-try. Delicious, refreshing, and prepared with purpose. There's tropical sunshine, funky monkey, and my favorite, Zenergy, packed with all the healthy stuff, you leave energized and glowing.
Pero sarap, grabe.
There's more food coming our way. See you after the break.
Wiener.
I have never been a coffee drinker myself, so I'm so glad they make a really good horchata.
So good and so refreshing.
From Seabuds,
ang sarap nito.
I head to another cool place just a stone's throw away. This is Clean Beach, brainchild of partners Harold and Kabil.
What we try to do is to give people their own small inch of safe space where they can work, hang out, discuss about ideas, conceptualize, have creative refresh rate and make it really high. So when they go back to Manila, they're decluttered, they're full of ideas, and they can take it home with them.
Thank you to the people like Harold and Camille who provide inspiring spaces like Clean Beach. Come for the food, the vibe, and the open plan, but definitely stay for the internet. I hear is the fastest in Surf Town. What to eat in Clean Beach? They make a really great kaya toast with ingredients all sourced locally. The egg is perfectly soft-boiled and the bread is baked fresh, and I love the touch of dashi.
This is very good.
It's easy to lose track of time here in San Juan, and breakfast can go on and on. I make my way to El Union Coffee at the Great Northwestern Travel Stop and Viewing Deck. Here, I meet up with one of the owners of this little coffee shop that could. What began in a rice stall has evolved into a San Juan institution serving specialty coffee. This year, El Union turns 8 years old.
Yeah, when we started the company El Union Coffee, it was really a way for us to live at the beach with our kids. That's really the heart of the company. It wasn't more than that. I didn't drink coffee until 2012. We started the company in 2013. So that's how quickly my coffee story developed.
El Union is the best example of the third wave coffee movement. From tree to cup, El Union sources local quality beans directly from the farmers in the Cordilleras, Benguet, Mount Apo, Cagayan de Oro, and Bukidnon. I have never been a coffee drinker myself, so I'm so glad they make a really good horchata. Years ago, also on FoodPrints, I tried horchata in Valencia. The Spanish version is made with chufas or tiger nuts, whereas El Union's version is made using rice. Horchata traces its origins back to North Africa, but it's more popular in Spain and Mexico. It probably came to our shores via the galleon trade, but it didn't take root in our culture.
Horchata kind of, I always say it fell off the boat somewhere, because we don't drink horchata. We eat lechon, adobo, etc. What we do is we roast the rice along with cinnamon sticks.
Yeah.
And then we have, and then we make a milk out of it the way that you would make almond milk or oat milk.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And then we strain and filter it, and then we combine it with dairy milk. We pressurize it in a keg and charge it with food grade nitrogen so that it has that silky texture.
So good and so refreshing.
Yeah.
Distributing online, Nationwide helped El Union pivot and survive the pandemic. The good news is, you can get horchata occasionally and their specialty coffee anytime by ordering online on elunioncoffee.com. Mabuhay kido and El Union! More food coming our way, so keep it here on FoodPrints.
This is an Ilocano vegetable called poke poke. Ang sarap niya. This one I really like, this version. It's finely chopped. Okay. This is very good.
In the north shore of San Juan, where the surfing beach meets the swimming beach, is Kabsat, the new kid on the block. It's spacious and airy, organic yet modern. It's a place you could lounge in all day. Kabsat translates to sibling in the Ilocano vernacular, and this Dipahat-inspired restaurant was built to welcome guests like family. The food is certainly perfect for the whole family. The servings are generous, and the menu offers plenty of choices. Here are just some of my top picks. Sugpo sa bawang at alige, Poki Poki, Tuna Salpicao, Ceviche, Steamed Malaga, Fish Tempura.
You know, in Japan, kasi, they have, of course, a dipping sauce, no? But I've learned to eat tempura with salt. So, yan, konting salt lang. Kamayin ko na to. You know one thing about having tempura with salt is you can taste the freshness of the fish and the crunch stays. Sarap din ang tempura niya.
Now let's try the buttered chicken, one of the most popular items on the menu.
Wow, let me try it without the sauce. Winner din. A little gravy. Sarap ng gravy niya. No, but I can eat it straight without the gravy. Sarap siya.
This was a really good buttered chicken. Moist and tender with just the right amount of batter. The next dish is very popular in the Ilocos region and it's something I always look forward to. They do it a bit differently here at Kabsat.
This is an Ilocano vegetable called poke poke. No, iba itsura niya, no? May konting atsuete siya. This one naman, it's made from grilled. Very important, grilled eggplant. It's a little bit sweet, it's very good also. Ang sarap niya. This one I really like, this version. It's finely chopped, okay?
What you're seeing is me having small bites of all these dishes. But when I no longer have to describe what I'm eating, I go all out. And the food they serve in Kabsat is the kind where you throw your diet out the window. Because to fully enjoy a meal like this, you will need a heaping serving of rice. Kaya sira na naman ang diet ko.
Cleaner.
But I don't mind with food this good and the ambience this inviting. Here's a tip. Kabsat has the best seats in Surf Town to enjoy the San Juan sunset. But come early. Claim one of the bamboo chairs on the deck, order a cocktail, and I guarantee it will be a sunset to remember. Speaking of sunsets, I've been invited to dine at Solarena Seaside Resort in Caba, which is about an hour away from San Juan. I try to make it before sunset. I catch the tail end and it's spectacular. Sunsets are always beautiful and no two sunsets are ever alike. So keep it here on Foodprints. Table has been set up outdoors and the vibe is very festive. It's dinner for three with Joseph Montelibano, who prepared this spread, and my old friend Mansky Nacimiento. I mentioned before that Mansky moved his family to Agoo since the beginning of ECQ. Joseph, meanwhile, is the creative force behind the Last Supper Kitchen at Solarena Resort. And he's prepared local favorites with a twist.
Okay, we can start with a classic, very home down version of a empanada. So it's open faced in a galette. So we call it the Northerner galette.
The Northerner galette is a marriage between the Ilocano empanada and the French galette. Joseph is a Bacolod-born New Yorker who spent time in Paris, learning how to cook, and his food is influenced by his background and experiences.
And then we have the chicken galantina, but of course, instead of the classic raisins that the Filipinos usually put, I did Philippine brand dried mangoes on it.
So it's like galantina ngubad, right?
Yes, naked galantina.
You know, I'm fascinated at how your mind is working and creating all the. Does it happen to you like sometimes you're sleeping and you wake up, oh my gosh.
Exactly, it's sometimes the craving too, like I want ham, but I also want grilled pork. So which leads me to introducing the Fiesta grilled pork.
The Fiesta grilled pork is Joseph's take on the traditional Christmas ham with the added aroma and flavor of charred meat. The Bacolod Inasal is cooked on a rotisserie instead of grilled, and it is a whole chicken instead of paa and pecho. And the salad is not your typical lettuce and tomatoes.
And then the eggplant ensalada, which I turned and treated into like a baked lasagna.
Mm-hmm. So you baked it?
Yes, we baked it and some magic spices in it.
I'm impressed with what Bing was presented for us. Galing, Bing.
They've perfected a number of signature Filipino dishes that they've been serving for decades as well. When you come here to Solarena, you can enjoy both the old from the kitchen of Solarena and the new from the Last Supper kitchen. I'll start with the classic kilawin.
Oh my gosh. The first thing I bit was the sourness of the fish, mildly cooked up from the outside because of the acid, and then the burst of spice. Whoa, sarap! Winner!
Papaitan is a staple in every Ilocano table, and it goes specially well with a cold bottle of beer. At Solarena, they make their papaitan with goat.
there's a little funk in ano eh, papaitan eh. Pero eksakto, sarap yung papaitan niya.
While I enjoyed the papaitan, Mansky was busy with the naked galantine. What do you think, Mansky?
The more I dig in, the more I find the mango bits, and it's a nice, you know, fresh touch to it. So
may crunch.
I like the
gives it the beachy vibe.
Yeah, para talagang pinag-isipan yun.
Nothing beats a classic kare-kare, and Solarena does it really well. It's rich and sticky, with tripe, which I absolutely love.
Masarap. Melt in your mouth, kare-kare. O nga, alam mo, even without the bagoong.
Masarap na siya.
Yeah. Did you know that the cups on the yung tuwalya, mm-hmm. that's where you put the bagoong? Yeah. So did you know that?
Actually, now I know. So.
No, I'm just inventing. Invento ko lang yung bari.
Kung may gout ka, makakalimutan mo yung
gout ka. Kakain ka nila. Bahala na!
Okay, now for something healthier and something I've never had before. Lasagna, eggplant, and salada.
So instead of ricotta, it's the salted egg.
You know, the salted egg somehow tastes a little bit like cheese. Eh?
Right. Yes.
Diba? Tapos, instead of your pasta, it's the eggplant, no?
Yes.
Ang galing, ha? And tapos you have basil, right?
Yes.
Ganda.
Basil on top to, ano. Yeah.
Actually brightens the dish. I like
it. What I noticed here is a lot of people who have events, let's say parties, weddings, debuts or whatever. Everybody wants to feel safe. And an open space like this, you have great food, beautiful scenery, privacy, di ba? And I think it's a whole complete package. Galing ng ginawa niya ni Bingo rito.
I can imagine a private dinner or an intimate wedding here at Solarena. I'm sure Joseph will put together something really unforgettable, just like this magical dinner we're having tonight. Bingo Manahan, whose family owns Solarena, finally joins us for drinks by the fire. Bingo is a good friend of my daughter, Ali, and any friend of my child is a friend of mine. Thank you, Bingo, Joseph, and Mansky. I totally see why you guys love it here. How wonderful it would be to fall off the grid and live in a place like this, closer to nature, back to basics. On the next episode of FoodPrints La Union, we visit a sea urchin farm and a vineyard. We have lunch on a raft, and we have a most delicious halo-halo. Wherever you may be, stay safe, be well. This is Sandy Daza. Thanks for watching.